all Big Pete fans. Today we've encountered another problem that we find ourselves on the road. PA men. Now, it comes in various gauges of what kind of PA person we get. Now, because we do our own commentary whilst we're doing the show, PA is very important. Because we like to whip up the crowd, we like to talk to you a lot, and we say, do you want to see dumb damage, and everyone gets behind us. So sometimes we turn up, and it's a loud hail on. Sometimes we turn up, and they're tiny, shonky little speakers. Sometimes we turn up, and they have really good sound equipment. And it's going to be great, that's really good for us. Sometimes you turn up, and you've got really good sound equipment, but they have no idea that it's a show and not Glastonbury. So as you can hear me shouting, these lovely people need to just turn the volume down, because I'm shouting to you, which is the same as everybody else is going to do as they're around here, shouting just to enjoy the day. Not only that, but they do the thing that I hate the most when they've got music, is they play a little bit and then go on to the next one. So you get half a song. If you're going to play a song, play the song. Stop changing it. So yes, PA equipment, PA people. I wish there was a standard. We know who are good. We know who are bad. This one's going to be challenging, because already I've got that ring-ting-tinning in my ears from the titanus. Tinnitus. Tetanus. Today's video, Michael, is about PA equipment. I've already done an introduction, because the PA equipment today, which is very good, was very unnecessarily loud. Now, why don't you tell us some of your favourite PA stories?
Well, like the time from last year where I was less than amused and I made the PA man cry.
That was like one speaker and a blown up amp, and the generator didn't have any fuel in, so he couldn't even do a radio check.
But he did try and tell me that it wasn't his fault.
It wasn't his fault.
That didn't really
work. And he added a qualification.
Yeah, yeah. And then he put a qualified sound engineer on it in the afternoon, and I've got shirts older than him. So that was one that's fresh.
He pressed play on the CD, didn't it? And he went dee 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 dee. And we're like, turn it off, just turn it off.
He just turned it down a bit, and then looked at
me. Yeah, he did. He turned it down.
Yeah, yeah. I said, look,
no, off.
How hard is it, dude?
Off.
Turn it off, and then. He turned it down and he looked at me some more. So I headbutted this monster truck. Well, we stood on the bonnet and I headbutted the bonnet. Bang, like that. And then I made him cry. Yeah, that was one.
We went...
Do you remember the time when we turned up and the silly old fella wired the speakers to the mains and they all set on fire?
Yeah, he pulled up with his little picnic bench, sat down on his little chair...
Yeah.
And then he started plugging it all. He looked like a Santa Claus, but one that had fallen
smelly,
on bad times.
Smelly old man.
He was like a crack Santa Claus.
It looked like coming a Volvo, an old Volvo.
Volvo,
estate.
Yeah.
It looked like he lived in it.
And then all of a sudden his speakers were smoking. And we're like, oh, I don't think that should be doing that.
Can we see if we can help you? What's wrong? And he said, well, I've just powered it up. Smoke's come out the speakers. And he put 240 volt into the speakers where the signal should go in.
We went to one place and the PA equipment was really poor, and then we went back there again and it was like, oh my god, this is a lot better than the crap we had last year. And he went, that was me.
So there were no, it was my big mouth, I went, well, there were no reversing from that situation, so I went, well, it was crap.
So PA equipment is very, very important to us, because
very important.
He talks on the microphone And I sometimes talk on the microphone, and we talk to y'all and we give a commentary as we're driving. If you've seen the show, you'll know.
This is a really...
I've got to swap hands, I'm getting shaky.
This is a small... Oh, hello, this is your good side.
This is my good side.
And this is a fairly small arena and it's got... Who's counting speakers today?
Oh, it was Bubba, he said there's 16 speakers.
16 speakers around this arena. And
some places we turn up and there's two in each corner. And that can be enough. On a good system. On a good system.
Bane of my life. Bane of my life. Yeah. Good PA system, good weekend, bad PA system.
So sometimes they'll be wiring it up in the morning. Oh, that was this year. We turned up, we've been there all week as we'd been, and then an hour before show time, they say, oh, can you help us put the poles into the ground for the speakers? An hour. Like, we get our race suit on half an hour before, and there we are with a forklift trying to help them put the speakers up.
Oh, it's an hour to show time.
It's an hour to show
time.
I'm
going to go and put my race suit on.
An hour? It'd be a bit...
There are good PA people, there are average PA people, and then there are ones that should just get another job. Because the ones that are bad... They put Michael in a bad mood, don't they?
Yes, and there's no getting him out of a bad mood.
Not when I've got the arsehole, there isn't. Gonna get changed, love y'all.
This is an unusual situation.
This is now showtime. Now, I don't normally climb out the monster trucks, but I thought, seeing as though we are doing a video about commentary and PA, I thought this is the best opportunity. So there's Grim Reaper, which I'll be driving. There's the scrap cars. There's Big Pete. And there's Michael. Now, I'll get up closer to Michael, but you'll see he's got his radio in, which is what's going on now. He's talking to all the people that have all come to see us. So he will wear that throughout the entire routine and drive and talk. We proudly say that we are the only people that drive a monster truck and commentate whilst doing it, which is not easy. Trust me, I can tell you. I usually scream and say all sorts of nonsense when I'm driving and commentating, so it's quite a bizarre show when I do it. But Michael, he's been doing it a fair few years, he's pretty good at it now. So hopefully in a second I'll get up close to him and we will hear him whip up the crowd, and then you can see why a good PA system helps make this show. Now, before I do that, I thought I would show you something that always tickles me. He can't help but walk and talk. When he's on the mobile phone, he'll walk off and you'll never know where he is. And here's a prime example. There's Big Pete, to which he's meant to be driving, and all the way over here, there, is Michael doing an old walk and talk. Now, usually, at the end of his commentary, he'll say, cue the music. To which we get a 10-second countdown before our theme music starts. And he gets really far away from the truck and he has to run back to the truck in time because he goes, right, cue the music. He goes, where am I? Ah!
Ladies and gentlemen, when we do the drag race, when we do the tug of war, when we do the car crush, we need each and every one of you to make some noise, because the louder you climb, the higher we fly. The more noise you make, the more damage we're going to do to these cars. What about it? Gino, do you want to see some damage? Yeah! Oh, come on, people. You can make more noise than that. What about it? Do you want to see some damage?
And the video abruptly ends, and here you are in my office, which is where I work during the week when I'm not off monster trucking. It may seem like we're being particularly hard on PA people and equipment, and we're probably going to have a lot of enemies. But the reality is those people are paid to be there. They are paid to put on a service. So when it's poor and when they're not great, we get frustrated because we feel, this may not be the case, but we feel we can't deliver as good a show, because so much part of our show is the embracing of the crowd and the integration that we can have. And if we can't do that, it takes away from that. And the trucks are only going to be active for around 15 minutes of a half an hour slot. So there's 15 minutes of dead air if we haven't got any ability to integrate with the crowd. So
that's the end of the rant, really. Like and subscribe and all that. See what next video brings. Peace out. Bye-bye.